This lecture is a continuation of the previous lecture where we learned how to create the basic dot plots. In today's lecture, we are going to create dot plots with R programming, which are grouped, sorted, and colored. So this is a bit more advanced version of dot plots compared to what we had learned in the previous lecture. So are you ready? Let's get going. This is my R studio, and this is where we stopped yesterday. We just used this much of coding to create the basic dot plots. Okay, just run this program and see. This is the dot plot that we had created in the previous lecture. Now moving ahead, we have to sort our entire data and then group them and then infuse color. These are the three things that we are going to learn. Okay, now the first step that what we are going to do is we are going to sort data frame empty cars, the same data file that we were using in the previous lecture. So we are going to sort the data frame empty cars by MPG. Okay, we'll be using miles per gallon for sorting, lowest to highest, and save it as a data frame X. Okay, so what we are going to do is, let me write a comment for you so that you can easily understand and you can pause the video and you can revise the same as well. Okay, so the purpose of this command, it sorts the data frame empty cars by MPG. Okay, and that is lowest to highest. Okay, and saves it as data frame X. Okay, so this is what we have done. The purpose of this command is that it sorts the data from lowest to highest and saves it in a new data frame called X. So let's see what the command is. We'll create a new data frame that is X equals to empty cars. Okay, now you have to use square brackets. Okay, square brackets are used to find certain things, okay, to seek out certain things, to search. So X, that's the new data frame, the name of the new data frame, equals to empty cards, and we are ordering the file empty cards as per MPG. Okay, the rows would be defined as per MPG. It's only related to rows, no columns required. So just put a comma, leave it, and close the square brackets. Run this part. Okay, next. The next part, the next command that we are going to do is, it transforms the numeric vector cylinder into a factor. Okay, this step, I'll write a command comment over here so that you can pause and you can take a note of it. This transforms the numeric vector cylinder, that is CYL, into a factor. Okay, this is important. So this command, the data frame X, now the new data frame X, out of which the cylinder, we are grouping as per cylinders. Okay, so X dollar cylinder, this is the new name given to that, equals to factor in brackets the data frame dollar the column name. Okay, the column name is cylinder. So from this data frame, this column is being converted or transformed into a factor. Fine. Okay, moving ahead, what we are doing next step, okay, we are adding a character vector color to data frame X containing the values red, blue, or dark green depending upon the value of cylinders. Okay, what we are doing is, depending upon the value of cylinders, we are assigning a color. Okay, should I write a comment for one, or I'll put a comment over here so that it will be commonly understood for all the three. Okay, because I have three types of cylinders: 4-cylinder vehicles, 6-cylinder vehicles, and 8-cylinder vehicles. Okay, so let's see. I'm putting a comment: adds a character vector color to data frame X containing the values red, blue, dark green. Okay, depending on the value of what? Correct, cylinders. Okay, depending on the value of cylinders. Okay, so this comment is commonly used for all the three. Okay, so what we are doing, X dollar, this is a new name that we are assigning, X dollar color, seek for the column cylinder in this data frame and look for 4. Okay, double equals to is for look for. Okay, so X dollar color, square brackets, X dollar cylinder. Now right now X is my new data frame. Okay, the name of the new data frame, empty cars, is X. So X dollar cylinder, double equals to 4, assign red, X dollar color, square brackets, X dollar cylinder, double equals 6, square bracket close, equals to blue, and likewise for dark green. So what I mean to say, the dots with red will represent 4-cylinder vehicles, dots with blue will represent 6-cylinder vehicles, and dots with dark green will represent 8-cylinder vehicles. Simple? Okay, now let's run these commands. Okay, I'm running this, then I'm running this, this, and this. So all the commands are run. Now it's my turn to create the dot chart. So the command is more or less the same, very simple. Dot chart, comma, X. This is the data frame out of which, what is the column we are using? Dollar MPG. Okay, then what is the labels? How will we get the labels? Labels would be as per the row names of my data frame X. Okay, CEX 0.7, that is the density, that is for the texture or pattern for my dots. Okay, you can keep changing it, not a problem. In a previous lecture I had shared a complete list for all the CEX values. Then we are grouping them. The grouping is done according to the cylinder, and the color will be taken from X dollar color. Okay, PCH point. In a previous lecture, I had shared again a table for PCH values as well. Okay, so right now I'm using PCH equals to 19. Okay, and the title for this, gas mileage for car models, and the X lab, that is labeling for X axis, is miles per gallon. Fine, this is the basic command for a dot chart. So once I run this, okay, so you can see this is my dot chart. I'll just expand it a bit for you. Yep, so you can see this is my dot chart. Now in this chart, a number of features become evident. Okay, again you see an increase in gas mileage as the number of cylinders increase, as the number of cylinders decrease, but you also see exceptions, right? For example, let us say I have a Pontiac Firebird. Okay, you can see its mileage is close to 20. This is an 8-cylinder vehicle, but at the same time you can see that Mercury 280cc, though it's a 6-cylinder vehicle, it has a lower mileage than this. So exceptions are there. Okay, now again, the Hornet 4 drive with 6 cylinders get the same miles per gallon as Volvo 142e. Okay, so exceptions are existing, but overall what you can see, you can also see that overall all the 8-cylinder vehicles are in dark green, all the 6-cylinders are in blue, and all the 4-cylinders are in red. So the entire dot chart is neatly split and arranged and organized. So I hope this is going to be quite useful for you, and hopefully you must have found it interesting as well. You can stay in touch with me on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter. You can write to me directly at rajeshdorbala@gmail.com. Thank you for your attention. See you soon.